My name is Adam Giambrone. I'm the former chair of the Toronto Transit Commission, and as well, I currently work as the director of planning and innovation for the AMT of Montreal, which is the regional transit authority. What happened at TTC is there was a discussion about what new fare payment mechanism they would use. There is the Presto card out there, which is a proprietary fare system that is relatively expensive. The government of Ontario has already invested $250 million with very little to show for it. And that would be okay, except that to fully implement Presto, it's going to be at least another $250 million, probably or possibly as much as $400 million. And because it's a proprietary technology, it doesn't allow you to change with the times. So it's very expensive. We don't know what's coming down. We don't know what will take off. I mean, Google Pay Wallet seems really great, and I think it's coming. But maybe it won't. Maybe something will overtake it before it really has rollout. And so it's very hard when you have a proprietary system to stay up to date. Or if it's not hard, it's certainly expensive. So at the TTC, we initiated last year, just over a year and a half ago, a process for open standard payments. And what that is really is just simply a term that says whatever the payment industry does, your platform will accept it. And so it's a really basic platform that uses the industry specs, the industry back office to support payment. So basically, I always explain anything that Tim Hortons will accept or Esso, the TTC would accept. And it really allows you to be a lot more flexible because you'll be able to adapt almost instantly and for very little cost to whatever technology is coming next. So there was an RFP, that's a request for proposal, so it's a public call. Anybody can respond. There were 11 responses. Three were deemed to be able to be technically sufficient and went forward, and there was a successful outcome. ASC won the contract, a big international firm that teamed up with Visa, MasterCard, and other smaller companies that had experience in transit. And what they offered was to cover the full capital cost of installation. So that was the what we were just talking about with Presto, $250 million. And they were also willing to guarantee. So one way you do is you can pay all the upfront costs and recoup it over 20 years. But the contract also required, and they met this, that there be a lower operating cost than today to collect the money. So the TTC spends 7 cents today to collect a dollar, and under the ASC proposal, it has to be lower, and it was substantially lower than that. So it was successful. In fact, Chicago literally just announced within the last week almost an exactly similar deal because the two requests for proposals were almost exactly the same, and Chicago's accepting it. Unfortunately, TTC, the government of Ontario, doesn't want to go open standard payments. It wants to go Presto. So Chicago's getting it. TTC isn't. And that's unfortunate because this would have saved hundreds of millions of dollars. And it also, with a proprietary fare system, generally they charge you more to collect the money. It has higher operating costs, somewhere around upwards of 10 cents per dollar collected. So this ASC deal would be much better. It's only politics which are preventing us from going forward here in Toronto. And of course, the frustrating thing about Presto, as we said, is it doesn't necessarily allow you to have the next wave of technology accepted, whereas the open standard payments would continue to evolve. And it is happening in transit. In Asia, it's very common to use cell phones. Here in North America, New Jersey Transit just announced they're using Google Wallet because they were one of the first to use open standard payments, New Jersey Transit and New York. So this is catching on across the industry. Montreal right now has the Opus fare card, which is like Presto. It's a proprietary fare technology. And they are moving to Opus 2.0, which will include open standard payments. So I would always say my analogy is, if you're looking for the future, you may not know exactly what it is, but are you willing to bet against the biggest corporations in the world? Google, Microsoft, Apple, Visa, MasterCard. I mean, this is huge. The micropayment industry is $6 trillion. The reason the credit card companies are willing to pay to set it up is they want the top of wallet. The card you pay, whether it's a bank card or your credit card, maybe your cell phone that you use for everyday transit purposes, and 90% of Torontonians use transit at least once a month, is more likely the way you're going to pay for other things. And that's where they make their money back. Not on the government or not on the transit user, but under other applications. So it's an exciting technology. It's coming, whether you like it or not. $6 trillion international micropayments industry, and just hope at some point that the government gets on board. I think the biggest obstacle is they feel that they don't want another e-health scandal. They've put $250 million to Accenture. They've got very little show for it. They do have a Presto system kind of up and running, but it's been going down. It's had problems with weather. The operators aren't happy with it because it hasn't proven itself. So they have $250 million invested, and they think if they walked away from it, it would look bad. Having said that, from a business perspective, although it's unfortunate, you never would want to waste any money. But if you had if you've already wasted $250 million, you're trying to recoup it. But if it's going to cost you upwards, say to put all Ottawa, Toronto, and the rest of them upwards of $500 billion versus zero, almost zero capital, not quite, there'd probably be a couple tens of millions to do some open payments infrastructure stuff. That would be the responsibility of the transit authorities. But if you're looking at that from a business perspective, you would say it's really bad that we threw away $250 million. But if we continue, we're going to cost another $500 million. So the better might is to write off the 250. But that's an embarrassing political decision to make, and I think that that's one thing that's holding it up. And the government of Ontario has been very stubborn in this. I think they want Presto. I think they're also outdated. They also see Presto as a way that they could sell to other people. You could use Presto for a whole bunch of things. Which is not a bad idea, but I think it's almost two decades old. They keep referring to Hong Kong, which has had a very successful rollout of a smart card, but they're one of the only ones. They've done an amazing job, but that's because that technology was pioneered in the 1990s when it was state-of-the-art, and it ended up working. They did it well. They probably got a little bit of luck. There may be some factors in Hong Kong that made it particularly successful. It hasn't been duplicated anywhere else in the world. Parts of it, but hasn't. So I think it's a little bit unrealistic. They're also about two decades late. And at this point, they're going to lose out, whether it's for transit or for the general industry, to the open standard payments, to the companies that I listed. They're just not going to be able to compete. Well, the reason transit's interesting is because so many people use transit on a regular basis, so it becomes part of their life. And as it become, and if you're using it in transit, you become comfortable with it, and then you sort of branch out into other things. I think you're going to see increasingly for the micro transactions, those are under $50, those are going to be increasingly geared towards open standard payments, so the NFC technology. And it's going to roll out. I mean, cash. People sometimes bring up the fact that you have to pay, like the merchant pays 1.5-2%. The reality is cash costs a lot of money to manage. It does take time. You have to manage it. It's a security risk. Whereas NFC does have some charges, but overall provides a lot higher accountability. You can track your purchases or your sales. It makes it a lot easier, and it's going to roll out. People want to use it. They want to be able to do this, and it's really just a matter of time. And anyone holding back, especially if they're in the micropayments industry, might not. If you're in the high-end sales business where you're selling hundreds of dollars of items, probably not as important, certainly not in the short run. But this is coming, and I think it's just a little bit foolish to think that you could fight against it. I'm excited to see, and it's not new, but it is new in North America and Europe to some extent. I'm excited to see the rollout of the Google Wallet, as well as the other main methods of payment with your cell phone. We haven't quite seen that. I'm also excited to see when people finally accept that this happens. I was in a taxi a couple days ago, and I think my fare was $8.50, and it's such a challenge paying for a taxi fare in Toronto. They don't really like it. Sometimes I kind of get the sense that maybe they're stalling. And yet, I always tell them in a nice way, and they say, I'm much more likely to use taxis more if I could just simply pay. And you see this in places like Taiwan with the T-Mobile money, where the whole is all integrated, makes it very easy. And it's you don't have to carry cash as a cab driver. And also, I look in my wallet, I don't have any cash because I forgot to go to the bank machine. Well, right now, I might not be able to take a taxi in all cases if I could just use this. And this is true of other, that's just one example. it's true of a lot of other industries. So I think it's going to revolutionize a lot of the smaller transactions in the city. And so I'm sort of excited about that. In terms of technology, they're all going to use the base technology, how they turn out. So some people, you know, may not want to pull out their phone all the time, so they'll have a little fob on their keychain if that's comfortable for them. There's we'll have to see exactly how creativity takes over, because I think once this becomes standard technology, people are going to come up with creative ways of doing it, and it becomes interesting. Also, the merging of the RFID technology into it. So, like for example, in transit, you know, you can warn people, especially at stations, that as they approach a fair payment line, they'll be charged because they have an RFID tag that once they go in and stay in a zone, I mean, there's different ways to prevent someone from being charged by just sort of glancing or walking by. But then you don't even have to pull out your wallet, or your phone, it's just you're charged. And I think that's going to be an exciting combination, because it allows you to do things, for example, in transit, of multiple door loading. Right, as people come in, they're charged, and the vehicle moves around a lot faster. So things like that are going to be exciting. I think it's going to roll out in certain centers a lot faster. I think major urban areas where there is a density of population, a desire, cell phone use tends to be higher. In Canada, there are parts of rural Canada where, frankly, cell phone penetration is a lot lower because they don't have signals over. So they're not as useful, therefore people have less of them. But in the cases of, so if we're talking about major urban centers, the Toronto, the Montreals, New York, Chicago's, and other smaller cities, I think you're going to look within the 3 to 5 year window, they're going to make up a huge chunk, not yet a majority, but a huge percentage of your microtransactions. Everything is good. The sunshine smile upon my face, my friends, a blessed hand in all my innovations. If there's a bed without a chance, I'm glad, oh, that I found, somebody who I can rely on. Is it the return of the space cowboy? At a planet to be good, vibes on. Cheaper kind of space cowboy vibe.